Everyone, welcome to another video. Luke here, and today we're playing Minecraft on Xbox One. This is a new series I'm doing on the channel, just to see if we can get the achievements, kill the Ender Dragon, and all that good stuff. So it could take a while. Created this world not so long ago. It's been a while since I played it, so I can't actually remember what the deal is. I think I was in the middle of building a house. So yeah, I platinumed this on PlayStation 4. Recently bought it on Xbox. Why is it not letting me out? Recently bought it on Xbox One just so I can put some content up for the channel, because all the stuff I put on the channel is Xbox gameplay and PC gameplay. There's no PlayStation 4 stuff on here, so I thought, hey, you know what? Why don't we just complete Minecraft on Xbox One and get all the achievements? At least that way we can do some cool videos of it. I know a few guys in the stream said they like watching me play Minecraft, so we've also got that at the weekend with Alfie. Got a world there, we do. So this is just something a little separate from that. Something we can kind of dip in and out of every now and then. And hopefully help you guys out if you're stuck with what to do on Minecraft. Or you guys can help me out, because I very often get stuck with what to do. So I started building this house. It's a big kind of log cabin. I'm just living underground at the moment until I get all my all the materials I need to make this house great. I should probably go to sleep. Probably should have secured the door as well. We could die. Alright, so the rain stopped. Obviously, when it is raining, you can still get quite a few mobs, quite a few enemies. So I would say always be extra cautious when it's raining in Minecraft. So right, the plan I think for this was to make it dark oak, I believe. Dark oak planks, got oak wood. Yeah, I was going to have a couple of layers to this. Alright, so all of this grass I'm going to get rid of. I did see a village over there. Ah, okay, that's cool. Let's go take a look over there. I think I may have investigated this when I first spawned in this world, but we shall see. Hopefully they've got some seeds for me. That's what I want. The first thing is when you come across a village. Ah, yeah, I've already done that. I always loot their garden. Always take all their good stuff from the garden, so you can you have food on tap. Then you know you can grow your own crops, and you're never going to go hungry. So you'll never die, unless you get killed by a creeper or something. So you can't legislate for that. That happens. Right, I quite like this wood that they've used, but I'm not going to steal any of it. I always like to keep the villages intact. And if you are ever short of XP, then come and help the villagers, because they seem to get a whole bunch of shit after them in the evening. So I'll take some of this wood, do a couple of layers of this in the house, maybe the floor. I actually think this would make pretty cool flooring if we did slabs of it. Okay, sugarcane. That will be very handy. We'll take some of that. Da-da-bam. Thank you. Yeah, on the PlayStation world that I haven't actually put anything on the internet. Like I said, there's no footage of that up. But the one that I got the platinum trophy for was it was awesome. I had railways going everywhere. We had a couple of nether portals. We managed to find the end, which if you don't know how to do, we'll probably cover that. That'll be in a much later video, I should imagine. To go kill the Ender Dragon. I think in the recent update they said the Ender Dragon actually respawns as well. So that's good. Where's my music on, Mr. Minecraft? Probably should be using a slightly better axe in this one as well, but hey ho. Right, okay. So I normally I'm gonna kill the sheep. I like having wool just for carpets and stuff. Yeah, I normally build a rough house, and whilst I'm building my main house, I'll live in the rough house. But I've literally just put a hole in the ground and decided to live in there for the time being, which is a slightly different way of doing it. But if you see my houses, or the foundations of my house are on a nice little hill over there, so good visibility. That's always another thing. Make sure your house is as well lit up as you can possibly make it. And I mean, high up is always good, but I would say sort of the mountains and the rocks around this house you see up there and up there, they're probably a little too high. I don't want to have to jump down every time or build a bunch of steps. That just gets tedious. So, all right. So if we make ourselves some jungle planks. Nope, we don't have any jungle wood, apparently. Acacia, there we go. Right, so I'm gonna make the flooring acacia. Now, do we build slabs or do we build? Do we use planks? Let's try slabs. See how that looks. Yeah, that's pretty cool. I like that. That's nice. There's always one block that just doesn't want to go where you want to put it. Not sure if I'll do this whole area. Like I said, I do like to have some carpet down as well, just to mix things up a little. No, we don't want you there. Yeah, I normally have a couple of people playing with me, Alfie and my wife. You know, we play this game together. So things get done three times as quick. Well, two and a bit. Alfie's normally running around killing stuff. Alright, I might have to change up the approach with to getting into my little hole, my little temporary refuge. So yeah, this is actually looking quite nice. Excited to see what we can do in this world. The beauty of this game is, you know, whenever you spawn in, you just do not know where it's going to put you. You don't know what kind of world you're going to get. You could be right next to a village. You could be on top of a mountain. You could be in a desert, as I spawned in recently before, and that was a tough world, very tough. Didn't last very long in that one. There was just no materials around me, so pretty difficult. Right, okay, so we need to get rid of this. We can probably now put this in a decent place. Okay. All right. Da-da-da-da-da. Alright, see, that's the issue with with planks. This is why we probably should have used planks. Yeah. Okay, first mistake. We'll have to put this right. Alright, so we sorted the flooring out. just about. We need to go get some more planks. And we also need some stone. I like to always do like a small layer. This is something I've just been doing recently, actually. Just a small layer of stone around the wood, just to break it up a little bit. Give it something nice to look at. I think we'll take a look up here as well. First things you do, obviously, build yourself a house, get yourself plenty of food, get your garden on the go, And then I like to obviously go out and try and find myself a cave to see if we can make some iron tools just to make things a little faster. Sometimes easier said than done. Coal doesn't go amiss even. I hear a zombie, which is a good sign. Especially if he's underground. Or in the wall. That'd be nice. Could be a spawner. We could have a chest full of stuff. Get a saddle and some golden apples already, or a carrot. That'd be cool. So gonna need a fair bit of cobblestone, just with the. I'm probably gonna put a stone roof on top of this house as well. Gonna give it an old-fashioned medieval style look. This thing looks pretty cool. It's pretty good in the fact that we are surrounded by a lot of cool stuff. A lot of different types of wood. Village nearby, although it's not the best village. We seem to have a lot of animals around here as well, which is always a good thing. Okay, that could be a cave down there. Ah, that's good. We have iron already. Good start. Like I said, it's always good to get some iron, get slightly better tools, just to make the whole process go. And I mean, whether you want to, with this amount, what you prioritize, whether you build your sword first or your pickaxe, you could probably, what we've got there. I think we'll have enough for both, actually, one of each. I know we haven't got too many torches on us, so I'm not going to venture too deep, but alright, it's a complete circle. So yeah, alright, not the best cave in the world, but there we go. Things you miss if you don't put torches down. Yeah, getting the platinum on this game on PlayStation was pretty difficult. When I look at how much time put into it, I mean, I've played hundreds of hours of this game on PlayStation. I seem to remember the most awkward one was all the colours of wool, getting all the different types of dye. That was a bit of a pain in the ass, but not difficult. Just you just need to gather a lot of stuff. Need to get some more acacia planks so we can finish that floor off. There is some coal. We might as well grab that while we're here. As long as we don't drown. Oh, that's gonna take too long. Oh no, I know we're stuck. I know we're not. Yeah, I quite like the roofs that the guys have got on the village. Quite like the way they've done their roof. Also, as well, this is positive. We have an opportunity here to get some pretty cool stuff. So if we go in here, to be very careful, because you do get plenty of creepers kicking around in these things. All right, so if you. Top tip: if you hit crouch, you can go over any hole and you won't fall down. Obviously, unless you dig directly below. Now this is careful. This is something you have to be careful with, because if you land on that pressure plate, there's TNT, layers of TNT below that, and you'll die. Pretty horrible death. But the chests around it do sometimes contain some pretty cool stuff. So if we just dig ourselves down, might be able to get some additional goodies before we get cracking and finishing the house off. Anything that's going to help us on this is welcomed. Alright, lots of bones. We'll take that. It's always good to have some bone meal. Got some gold horse armor. That's good. Here we go. First achievement we can do. An easy one. Give some hunger by eating rotten flesh. Okay, maybe we weren't hungry enough. Whoa. Right, hang on. If we get rid of some of this stuff. Get rid of the sand. We didn't need none of that. We'll take the enchanted book, respiration, that's very good. More bones, plenty of apples. Golden apple, that'll come in handy. Could always do with some string. Can't seem to collect that. Put the clay back. Blue hardened clay, cool. Apples. Yeah, we'll take the string just for fishing rods and stuff. More horse armor. I'm not sure how much of that we need, but we might as well take it. We are carrying a lot of crap we don't need at the moment. That wood sword is bringing nothing to the table. We're surrounded by oak wood, so we can afford to get rid of that. Sandstone. You'll take the spider's eye, it's always good for potion making. Jesus, gold bars, that's what we want. Sorry, gold ingots. You see, the problem with the horse armor is it does take up an individual slot. They don't group together. Okay, so we need to carefully navigate our way around that button. And get the hell out of here, because it's now getting dark. Ah, coal. More coal. Alright, we have to be careful with gravel. You can die under it. Alright, this is now pretty risky because we are in the dark, and there we go. Back to our house. No, hang on. The reason we came over here was for some of this stuff, if I remember right. Take some of that with us. Okay, we're not actually taking any of that with us. Get rid of that. And we're on our way. Obviously need to keep our wits about us a little bit, because we are in creeper territory this time of night. It's a risky game to be playing with not much lighting, and we are on hard as well, so we're being a little bit dangerous here. Weapons equipped. Let's get the hell out of here. As you can see, there's zombies. Skelly bobs over there. Spiders, more zombies, and when the grass is this long as well, it's a bit of a pain in the backside, because you get creepers just sat there, and they're difficult to spot. But we have made it. I think there's a skelly bob near our house as well, which is not good, but because they're the ones, they seem to do the most damage. No, that was just a flower. False alarm. We can handle flowers, that's fine. Zombie. Alright, well, we might as well get a little bit more of the floor done while we're here. R2 Wolf, and I will pick that up in a moment. KC Blanks, there we go. I don't mind killing the old zombie. Thank you. Yeah, it's very important to keep your XP high. As you guys will find out when we get the enchanting table. Because the higher your XP, the better your enchantments you get. So, oh no, that's bad news. See what I mean? I just heard his feet. Sounds like he's wearing a tracksuit. Shuffling along. Go on, Mr. Creeper. Don't you dare. See, with an iron sword, he would be done by now. Alright, they're sliming all sorts now. We should probably sleep, I think. Would be the best bet. Hopefully we're safe. Hopefully we'll wake up. Yes, we did. Right. We put some of this stuff away. Okay, I hear that slime. He's obviously not gone. Right, all the horse armor and books and stuff can go. Saddle, don't need the bones. Ah, hey, Mr. Pig. Still need more of this stuff. I thought we'd honestly thought we'd have had enough. 36, no chance. I think I'm gonna start building the sides of the walls up though today, just to give us a little bit more protection, because once we kind of enclose ourselves here, we can't actually do this work at night and not be in danger of being crept up on, as you saw. I think as well we might need to make those a little higher, because the floor is not as right. Okay, we're gonna need a couple of those. I'd like to have a row of furnaces anyway, so we'll put half in there, put a cobblestone in there, put the other half there with some more cobblestone, put the iron in there with some planks. Right, okay, so, yeah, I mean, really and truthfully, we should probably go and get just enough KC wood to finish this off. Right, dark oak planks. We'll make some of those. Across here. Gives us a little bit of protection from the creepers. Don't know how you guys do your house, but like I said, I'm going through this phase at the moment. You notice I've left a little space there for the a row of stone to go in, that I might even extend. We shall see. Two. Okay. All right. The door's gonna have to be a single door, I guess. That's not a problem. Do some different coloured planks around the doorway. A little bit of oak. I like to normally have double doors, but I've messed up a bit here and no, I haven't messed up. Okay. I thought that fell off center. Never mind. Right, so we knock that down. Get rid of that. Put that there. Two doors in the middle. There we go. And then we'll have our a little bit of oak going around it. Like I said, I'm going to make this actually one bigger. Should I? Because when you come in here, the ceiling's going to be very low, isn't it? Yeah, it's going to have to be. It's going to have to be. Right. Quite like the I think I like the dark doors. Yeah, I think I like those. Not sure why I made six. Can never have too many. Yeah, cool. Pop some stone in there. So, start filling these gaps in while I'm here as well. Dark. Fill that in. So, raise that up one. You can really build these houses any way you want, but like I said, I'm just going through this weird phase of thinking that this looks cool at the moment, so. Alright, the planks ran out. Right, lovely old job. So, a little bit of stone down here. Should be getting there now. Okay, boost these up. Do we want to add a back door to it as well? I think we probably should. It's always good to have multiple angles to get out with. Gonna build another row of this up. Normally wait for my windows to go in last. I'll build a house solid wood and then just go by where I think the windows should go. Get my axe out, create a hole. See, I'd probably like windows in here, actually. Gonna need some glass at some point. This could look cool, actually. Probably a bad idea putting the sword away. This could look cool. Well, definitely got enough apples to survive for quite a while. Just get our last little pieces of acacia wood, so we're definitely done with that now. Here's Skelly Bob. Yeah, these trees are a bit of a bit of a premium, so I need to make sure I can do actually have enough to finish this. Getting dark again. Oh no. Boy, you should never go out of the house without a sword. I'm being super dangerous. Sitting there, silly bastard. Damn, you very nearly killed us. These stupid little villagers. Okay, alright, we're gonna be risky. That we got now 14. That's probably not going to be enough. Zombie, has he seen us? Yes, he has. All right, he's not pursuing. That's fine. Enderman. We do need to kill a bunch of those. Especially if we want to. Uh-oh, that's bad. Zombies, skelly bobs, creepers I can handle, but witches. They are a pain in the ass. Quite a lot of stuff out now. Probably gonna head home. We are surrounded by creepers and zombies. Look at all them dudes just sat there, waiting for us to run by so they can kill us. Nope, we don't want none of your business, Mr. Zombie. Leave us alone. Well, at least we've got a little bit of protection now with the house. We have actually got a door on it, which is handy, and some sides up. Goddamn spiders. Oh, leave me alone. Oh god, Skelly Bob, right in front of the house. Yes, we done him. Thank you, baby. Let's get back inside. That's not what we want to do. Alright, good effort. We lived. I think we should have enough. I'm hoping that's going to be enough. to fill in these last little bits. All right, a little bit hairy there. Could have gone wrong, but luckily it didn't. I think we're just gonna make it here. This should be enough. Yes, 28. Plenty. Actually, Right, where am I gonna have my bedroom? We'll worry about that later. We're just going to put it down here for now. Also, we've got to move all this stuff as well. Okay, no bother. Alright, right, so I always like to have a few chests. So I'll likely do a... I normally have like a little junk chest in my bedroom. I'll do a food chest here. Whoops. Do a food chest here. And then this side will do a chest for any kind of cool materials that I find. So diamonds, gold, all that good stuff. Put some materials in here that we're not going to need right now. Yep, all that goodness. Stone, dark oaks. Gonna need those. And as for food, now. Valuable stuff, that. It's pretty much all we've got really for valuables, obviously, apart from downstairs and there. So we break that up. Okay, then just go divvy all this stuff up upstairs. Food in there if I remember rightly, so shouldn't take too much longer. Oh yeah, it's always handy to have a chest for just some stuff like feathers, bones, leather, that kind of stuff. General stuff. Alright, we have 42 books, that's very good. I must have taken those from the villagers. And then we have our armor, gold, more meat. Thank you, Mr. Torch. And we can now fill the hole up. Alright, so we're in pretty good shape. Got a lot of good stuff already. Haven't got many metal blocks, ingots or nothing. Obviously no diamonds either, so room for improvement, but considering how early we are in the game, not really finished our house off yet either, so can't grumble at that. What was I gonna put in there? I can't remember. Sun is now coming up, so we can build
Cool. Put ourselves a little doormat down. Better get some light up in here as well. Sleep now. No, oh, there's monsters nearby. Not the fact that it's actually daytime still. Get off my lawn, bitch. No! Don't you blow up all my hard work. Oh, you motherfucker. Look at that. That's the problem with creepers. God damn you. Okay, well, it's not the end of the world. Just an annoying part of it. Okay, so my many oak doors can go away. I picked up a little bit of string there as well, more white wool too. Okay. So we need to get this finished off really, so we've got full protection. So what are we going to use? Birch planks? I think oak will be the way to go at the moment. I don't want it to be too dark in here. God damn it. Right. I thought I saw a creeper around. Oh, that's bad. Whoops. God damn it. Need to be careful that that creeper does not end my world, because I would be very pissed off if he blows the side of my house off. Okay, I'm gonna need a little bit more dark wood. Can't remember where I got that from either. This is the trouble. Right. That's just oak, isn't it? Nope, that is. That's what we need. Well, my days. I'm being risky here. Goddamn things. All right, that's good. Plenty of nice dark oak. I did see some spruce over there as well. That would have been maybe better than using birch. I think because I've used birch on so many of my houses, I get a little bit bored of it. I'm just pouring at the air. Right, there we go. Crack on. You have to watch out when you come in these areas as well, because obviously there's no direct sunlight when it's shaded over like this with a canopy up ahead. You can still get mobs in here that don't get fried by the sun, because obviously they're sheltered by it, so do have to keep your ear out. Alright, we'll go till this axe is dead. We've got more than enough. How about a little bit of spruce? That should be enough. I'm just thinking about having some partitions inside the house with the spruce wood, just to separate the bedroom and maybe put an area for furnaces and stuff. There we go, that'll do. It's time to call it a day when you've when your axe breaks. House is looking pretty cool. Obviously, no windows in there at the moment. But that is a very deliberate thing on my behalf. God damn it, that fucking piece of grass just freaked me out. We'll try and eventually get all this even around the house. I don't like having too many divots, especially near the house, because if you're trying to get back in a hurry, if you're being chased by stuff, then that just slows the whole process down. So, oh, there's, I hate this grass. I think area-wise, we're pretty central. We've got a nice flat area down there. We'll probably put the garden right nearby some water. The house is up on a hill, so yeah, I think as far as that's concerned, we're in a good place, but that's not good. Oh no, you don't. Right. So, we can now go finish the roof off. Obviously, doing this at night, you have to be very careful with skellybobs, because they can shoot you, and on hard they seem to do a lot more damage. I'm not actually sure if they do or not. Probably should have found that out before I made that claim, but alright, there we go. Now, do we need another one? Probably not. I think we'll just use some cooked stone. Whoops. That was an accident. Alright, we're not going to have enough to even go nearly all the way around the building. So next mission, we need to find some coal. I think that's that should be high on our priority list. How are we set for food? Yeah, we're in quite a good place for food, so. Yeah, no need to panic on that front. So this is how I do the roof. I'll just keep doing that, working my way in a little bit. So it's like a stepped roof. But, oh wow. Hey. He's in the house. Yeah, we definitely need to torch this area up. That's what happens when you don't. So we'll just sleep. Set the spawn point to here. We have daylight. Right, I'm probably going to pick this up in another video. Probably going to continue this next time, so going to cut it short there. We're going to call it a day on that one. Yeah, next objective, we really need to get the roof finished, set the garden up, and then go try and find a cave, really, so we can start to get some diamonds and gold ready to enter the nether, and some obsidian, obviously. So, yeah, lots to do. But like I said, this is going to be a series. I'm just going to pop a Minecraft video up maybe once a week. I'm going to continue this world. So it'll be quite slow progress, but it's a game that takes such a long time. I may even play, not record it, and then when I come back in to the world, you'll see that there has been some progress made. I'm not going to do too much without filming, obviously, but but yeah, so there we go, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. If you liked the video, same deal as always. Give me a thumbs up, comment in the comment section below. Let me know how you build your houses. Any suggestions, anything you want me to do. Any things you've seen me do in this game that you think maybe are not the right way around doing them. Or any cool ideas for the roof, cool ideas for windows and stuff. Let me know. Hit me up in the comment section. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out.